Hi everyone, it's Olga Zar from SEO Sly. Today I want to show you how you can learn more about Google Search Console data, how you can get more out of this data using JetOctopus. JetOctopus has this feature called GSC on steroids, which is basically showing you how GSC, showing you more data from GSC and letting you make more sense from it. So what you need to do is log into JetOctopus, choose your project, and then in this side menu, you will see Google Search Console keywords. And this is basically Google Search Console on steroids. So what you can see here is way, way more actionable than you see in GSC, especially if you are not a GSC nerd as like I am. So overview lets you see like the high level overview of GSC data, which is way more in depth than what you see in GSC. For example, you can see the number of total keywords, which is, as you can see, way higher than you have the sample data in GSC. Normally, the sampling, I think, is limited to 1,000 keywords. And here, this sampling does not apply, and you can see the total keywords. So this is the number of keywords which are ranked in Google over a given period. Of course, you are free to choose the period, like 7 days, 30 days, 90 days, whatever suits you. And I can see that the number of total keywords is 25K, which is quite okay. The same with impressions, the same with clicks, and active pages, which is the pages that are actually shown in GSC that have either impressions or clicks. And it is not easy to get that information in GSC without like applying a lot of filters, doing some extractions, exporting the data here. This is the first thing you see in the GSC overview. So total keywords, total impressions, total clicks, active pages. Here you can see rankings and visibility, which is another useful chart, which is basically about how many pages have got rankings in Google search results over that period. So I can see that 400, so quite okay. Performance, the same thing, impressions, clicks, CTR. So this is more or less what you have in GSC. Here you can see performance by device. So the mobile, desktop, you can see where you are performing better. Here is a different chart dividing the data into mobile and desktop devices and countries. What countries bring you the most traffic? Let's go into problems, because GSC, except for I think the indexing report, does not really show you any problems. You can see some issues in the indexing report, but very often those issues are not really issues. And here you have the preset number of possible SEO problems, which again, you cannot really find that easily in GSC without doing a lot of custom filtering. So here you can see zero click pages. This is like super, super interesting. This can be a potentially a very quick win for you. So zero click pages are basically the pages that get a lot of impressions, possibly have quite high rankings because they get to be displayed, but have no clicks. So this is something that in most cases you really want to dive deeper into. Then pages with impressions not in crawl, so pages that weren't crawled, non-indexable pages with GSC impressions. So this can be, for example, pages that have a canonical tag set by you to something else, but Google chose different canonical and this page is still shown, or a redirected page which still gets shown in search results because Google like hasn't really removed that from index. So this can be an interesting thing to check if you are, for example, analyzing the impact of migration. Non-200 status code pages with GSC impressions. So this is very important. You have to really check that if you have a lot of pages there. Also keep in mind that this can be, those pages may not necessarily be up to date. Sometimes you will see like a lot of pages here, but when you click on them, you see that actually they are not 200, non-200 anymore. So this is, again, this is a very, very useful tool. But your task as an SEO is to go through those pages and actually confirm whether this is an issue or this isn't an issue. And indexable pages without impressions. So you have some pages, but they're like totally dead, not even shown in Google. So this is also something you probably want to take a look at, because this may be pages that do not really matter to you, like privacy policy pages, for example. They are indexable, but you don't care about them ranking, and probably they won't rank. But if these are important pages that you really care about, then you should take a deeper look. So this is the data from my own website. So let's look at zero click pages and see what's actually there. So once I clicked on that, I moved to data tables with filtering applied for those specific settings. These are the pages that get impressions, but which do not actually get clicks. This is an interesting thing. So this is the URL, an anchor jump link to a specific section in my guide. And this gets impressions, but this one does not get clicks. But it doesn't mean, for example, that my specific page without that jump link doesn't have any clicks. So you have to be careful when analyzing that. But this may also mean that this page has a featured snippet and it like totally answers the question, and Google people simply do not need to like click on that. This can be the case, and it is like your task to analyze it. So another one, a similar thing, jump link. So I'm not very concerned about those. Here, jump link. As you can see, mostly these are jump links. Here is one paginated page, like page 8 of blog. So that's totally okay. I am even I'm astonished that it's even shown in Google. Jump links. Category. So I'm not really focusing on having my categories rank for anything, so that's okay. And this is like category JavaScript, so like podcast episodes. So some podcast episodes, these are basically notes, are not, I don't really optimize my podcasts for like specific people who show in podcasts. If this is a person who is less known, sometimes those podcast notes do not get organic traffic. They only get organic like from what I share on social media, for example. So this is, again, okay for me. So your task basically is go through all of them and look for potential opportunities where you, for example, rank number 9 or 11. So you are just on the second page. And as we all know, the second page of Google is the best place to hide a dead body, right? So look for opportunities here for pages that rank well and which you can optimize to so that they start getting those clicks. Usually, improving those pages will be easier than building a new page from scratch and rank it. Usually, you need at least 6 months for a brand new page to realize its SEO potential to the full. So this is super, super useful if you want to quickly look for problems in GSC, real SEO problems. I strongly recommend you go to this GSC keywords report in JetOctopus and check simply for problems. And there are, of course, other super useful things. So here you have bot dynamics. Dynamics shows you like basically the changes that are happening with you. So for example, I can see that there are 300 pages whose rankings changed over the given period. Impressions change, clicks change, position change. So there have been a lot of changes within my site because the core update is now running. And even though we see those positions down, I know from my own experience and from analyzing the entire picture that this is not really an issue, because the pages that lost visibility, clicks, impressions are the pages that shouldn't really rank for some of those keywords anywhere. And the pages that I care about, the keywords that I care about, actually are doing okay. So this is where your actual SEO human brain is necessary to interpret this data, because JetOctopus is clearly seeing there are things going down. You can see clearly what's going down. and you can clearly analyze whether going down or going up is a positive thing. So you can see growth by impressions, clicks, the same here, drop by impressions, clicks. So we can see exactly what pages dropped, what pages gained, and you can dive deeper into possible causes and whether this is really a problem. So super, super useful. Dynamics for looking, having a better outlook into the changes that are happening in GSC. Insights. Again, some more meaning to the data from GSC. You can see clicks by position, so you can see depending on the position you have, how many clicks, what's the CTR. There are some like general numbers to aim for. So for example, if you are position one, you can expect like 30-40% of CTR. But of course, you need to remember that it all depends on the query and what's actually in SERP. Sometimes position one is below the fold and you will never get 50% of clicks. So this is like general information for you to see where you rank and what's the click-through rate. And you just, of course, need to analyze it in depth to make sense of it and look for opportunities for areas where you can actually improve that. Because not always you can improve that, not always it makes sense to try to improve that. It's again your human element that's necessary, and AI still is not able to do that. So queries performance by word counts are all queries grouped by the number of words. So you can see the CTR dynamics. So depending on how many words there are in the query, you can see the CTR. And here by query words is the dynamics of impressions, clicks, CTR, depending on the number of words in a query. Super, super interesting as well. And this one is also interesting. Top queries by clicks. Simply, you can see what queries bring you the most clicks and what the CTR of those queries is. Cannibalization. I have a separate video about cannibalization, but it's definitely worth looking at that here as well. So cannibalization basically shows you what queries are cannibalized, and you can like just click view pages and you can instantly see what pages are cannibalized, which means they rank for the same query and possibly compete with one another. So for example, Google Search Console, I have that many 8 pages that rank for Google Search Console, or I can have how to search for PDF on Google, and these are like six pages, but I see they are all about from the same page because they are simply like jump links. So this is not a problem in this case. Or site query, this is okay, right? I want a lot of my pages to be shown. So this is a problem. This may be a problem if you have like very close tutorials which compete for the same query. So if you see jump links, usually this is not a problem, but if you see quite similar topics, it means that Google is not really sure which one is the best one, which one should be canonicalized. So in some cases, you may want to simply merge them into one, redirect the other ones, depending on what's the best course of action. In some cases, you may leave both and have 2 spots in search results, but in most cases, this is not actually recommended. But again, as everything in SEO, it depends. So positions, for a deeper dive in positions, this is cool, rankings by positions. So this is a breakdown of all your rankings by concrete positions to see at what positions mainly you are getting the majority of rankings. So super, super useful. You can do it by period and by segments. Countries, it is quite easy to see countries in GSC, but you can also see more quickly rankings. You can see how many pages have rankings in Google over a given period of time. I can see, for example, United States is on top. There is Russia, there is United Kingdom, India, Brazil. So good to know. Dynamics, similar thing, how things are changing in those countries, and top 10 by impressions. So my most impressions, clicks come from the United States, India, Brazil, United Kingdom, and so on and so forth. Another thing quite interesting here is Google News, which is a new thing. If you have data from Google News, you can take a deeper look at that here. I don't have clicks from from Google News, so I don't have any data here, but if you do, then you can really make more of that. And Google Discover, which basically lets you see how you are doing in Discover. You can, of course, choose different period and then see. For example, my Google Discover traffic died some time ago, so I have to select like a longer period, and I can see my pages in Google Discover, on what days they were shown, for example, the impressions, again, clicks, super, super useful. So that's about it. I wanted to shoot a short video, but as always, I failed. If you want to learn more about Google Search Console data, make more sense of it, have more actionable tips from that data, make sure to check GSC keywords in JetOctopus. I hope this video was helpful and see you in the next one. And don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, add comments. This really helps my channel grow. All I'm doing here, I'm doing for free. I'm sharing my knowledge with you for free. Thanks and see you soon.